we're the 0.05 or 1% of the world that can actually do this.
Ball speed, I've averaged about 218 miles an hour.
The control fury that we have in long drive.
Club head speed, somewhere in that 145 to 148 range.
That's what makes this sport a little bit crazy.
Yeah, baby!
Go, go, go. That's all you wanted to do.
It's their sport's biggest stage, where a $250,000 winner-take-all purse is at stake.
To be that guy who hits the ball further than anyone else in the entire world, this is amazing.
This is the RE/MAX World Long Drive Championship. Match 9, Kimihiro Minamidi versus Patrick Hopper. The winner's going to Vegas. The six-time Japanese champion, Kimihiro Minamidi, squares up on ball two.
Good ball by Minamidi.
3-6-9.
That doesn't scare Hopper for a number, but it scares him that he has to hit the grid.
Two chances for Hopper to pass Minamidi.
Patrick has got a lot of long drive experience, and he should know better in this situation to make a mark. There's a good ball.
That one big.
That's why we get six. That will fly past everything. Bye-bye. And it's going to stay in.
Will it?
Yes, it will. At 300. 6 inches. And 89 yards.
Wow.
That is pure.
Ball.
That's vintage Hopper. Yeah. And is that a number Minamidi can touch? I don't know.
Final ball and set one from Minamidi.
OB left.
Hopper is one way from making the RE/MAX World Long Drive Championship final, October 8th.
Set two.
Not a breath of wind here at the Mesquite Sports and Event Complex.
Minamidi, ball three.
All of Japan and the sport of long drive resting on the shoulders of Minamidi.
3-5-0.
Again, Minamidi takes the early lead, applying pressure to the South Carolinian. Hopper says he doesn't long drive for fun. It's not much fun hitting them OB. Through four balls, that's what he's done. Hopper takes the lead on ball five. Extending his position on his final ball, his biggest of the match.
There it is. And it just takes one, and it's huge.
397.
372 is the longest Minamidi hit today. Can he find 25 more yards?
OB left.
Patrick Hopper, let's hear it for him. Congratulations.
To come out here to the only event that really, really matters and do this is awesome.
Hopper's the first to come out of the loser's bracket and punch his ticket to the Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Match 10, the 5 seed, Michael Knox versus Aaron Mansfield, the 12 seed. Mansfield squares up ball two.
3-7-9.
Knox connects with ball two as well, although not solidly.
3-1-8.
Knox continues to struggle, hitting it on the face. His final four balls go out of play.
Go! Stay there.
OB right.
Mansfield's one winning set from Vegas and his second October 8. Mansfield strikes first in set two.
I hit that ball so good. It was perfect for the wind conditions. It just hit the ground. I saw it on the Jumbotron rolling out from like 360 to 384.
Will it hold up? Five balls remain for Knox. The 24-year-old fails to hit it past the 384 mark. Mansfield does not build upon his lead.
Mike Knox has got a little open door here. 50, 60, and it's going to be short. And Aaron Mansfield, welcome to the October 8. Welcome back. He's one of the elite players in the RE/MAX World Long Drive.
I never really found it today in this competition. You got to have it every single day.
Two more have earned their place in the October 8. The week began with 192. Two matches remain. Who will take it deep in the desert and take their place in the October 8? Match 11, the injured Cody Zurich versus the man who started long drive a year ago, Will Hoge. Hoge starts strong, hitting the grid on both ball one and two.
This Hoge kid is strong. Like his action.
Come on, baby.
That is big right there. That is huge right there. That is over 400 yards right there for Will Hogue. Take that, Cody Zurich. I mean, you are going to have to step up.
Zurich fails to hit one in bounds through five.
This guy's got to believe in himself. He lacks a little confidence, and he needs to fill it up.
He needs 400 on ball six. Hogue's one win away from Vegas. Both feel the pressure in set two.
Go!
OB right. Duck hook OB right.
You gotta play golf. I can't believe what I'm witnessing here.
Nine swings, nine OB. Will anyone hit the grid?
We might have one in play.
At least go down with a number on the board.
Sure.
360. So there's 360. He could win the match.
Can Hogue last ball and celebrate? Or will Zurich's lead hold and force a decisive third set?
OB left, OB left.
Ball two from Memphis's Will Hogue.
Here we go, and this is it. To go to the Las Vegas Motor
there
Speedway.
Is, that's it.
He's gonna make Cody get him.
378 applies the pressure on Zurich. Cody is totally out of sync, rushing each shot.
And he's not using 25 seconds right here.
Ball five.
It just takes one in long drive, yeah. Does it not? This is huge, this is huge.
He might be about a yard short.
That ball should have rolled. That is a yard short.
Finally squared one up, I screamed at it. It just didn't roll out far enough.
Hogue misses the grid on his last ball. He maintains a slim 1 yard lead. It all comes down to the final swing for Cody Zurich. Who's going to Vegas?
Yeah!
He caught it.
Stay in ball!
Wow, look at this.
I hit it really well, and it just turned over a little too much and was out by a few feet at over 400.
You said 192. You're now one of eight going to Vegas.
That's right. I don't know what to say to that, really. I'm just happy.
Congrats.
Thanks, man.
Match 12, the final match. One of these two will be the final member of the October 8. AJ Evans versus Tim Berg. Evans takes the lead on ball one with 351. He extends the lead with his 380-yard drive on ball three.
Oh, he peppered this one. This is hit.
Berg struggles in set one, missing the grid on his first five swings.
That's Berg's big miss. He's down and across. After last year, I'd have taken 12 straight months and learned how to hit a draw.
It only takes one. Can Berg get it done?
Yes!
OB left. Happy OB, we're all OB.
The man from Middle America is one winning set from Las Vegas. Frustrated with set one's performance, Berg takes it out on ball number one.
A huge carry, more than 380 yards in the air, just gone.
399.
Evans fails to pass 399 on his next five swings. He chose the hammer position for just this moment, but fails to keep it in play. Berg takes set two.
Tim Berg stays alive. We go to a third round.
It's going the distance in this final match. The lower seed has won each of the first three losers bracket matches. The winner of the first set has gone on to win every match. One of those streaks is gonna end here and give us the final member of the October 8. Evans gets on the board early.
369.
Yes!
Berg takes it up a notch with his fourth swing.
That's a big ball. This just took it right past him right here.
395.
After thousands of swings this week, the competition comes down to its final one.
OB left.
Tim Berg, congratulations.
I'm glad to be back in the finals. Last year, finished second, so I want to get it done this time. I definitely don't want to come second again.
Tim Berg, the last man to join the October 8. Eight men with one goal.